I'm Kurt Horn with Fleet Lending Solutions out of Dallas, and I'll be your presenter today for the basics of evaluating a deal. Our goal today is pretty simple. We're going to provide you a method that we use for evaluating a deal to determine its viability prior to submitting it to a lender. Now, first and foremost, you need to know your lender's guidelines. If you know your lender's guidelines, it makes everything easier. We don't waste the borrower's time, the bank's time, or your time trying to send something that doesn't fit. So know your lender's guidelines, and now onto the presentation. There are six items that we use at Fleet Lending Solutions to gauge the viability of a deal when we're speaking with a customer and or prior to sending it to a lender. We flowchart these six items to determine whether a deal is doable or not. Now, the first and most important thing is time in business. When a business is a startup or a seasoned business, every business is going to fall into one of those categories. And startups, just by nature, are going to be more difficult to place. But if we know which lenders will do startups, it makes it easier. A quarter of our lenders will do startups. The other 75%, we send it in. We've just plugged everything up. We've wasted everyone's time. So it's important to know time in business, or are they a startup or seasoned business? The second thing we look at is time in industry. Time in industry is critical specifically for a startup because the lender wants to know that the person they're about to provide money to has some knowledge of the industry or the arena that they're about to get into. So time in industry is going to be more critical for startups than seasoned businesses. The third thing we look at, again, is more focused towards the startups, is the personal credit. Obviously, this is a huge factor for startups because they have no business credit. So the hope from the bank is that their personal credit will drag over into their business life. So if you've got a guy that's a 700 plus credit score, they believe that that guy will take his business as serious and tend to his credit issues as quickly with that as he does in his personal life. The next thing then that we look at, if they're not a startup, is their business credit. Their business credit for seasoned businesses, which is usually 2 to 3 years, depending on the lender, it can outweigh someone's personal credit pretty quickly. If we have demonstrated proof that they make their company payments on time, that will quickly outweigh personal credit. They'll still factor that in, but it'll be less significant. Frequently, we'll have guys that have a 660 credit score, and we'll be able to slide them through the system quickly because they may have 5 or 6 years time in business. We take a guy the other week that had 750 credit score, hit all the right stuff, but his 750 was thin. So it's easier sometimes to get lower credit scored people through with time in business than it is high credit score startups. The next thing we look at is age and condition of equipment. Simply put, newer equipment's easier to finance, and typically it gets better rates, terms, and it gets through the system quicker. More lenders want newer, better equipment than stuff that is at its end of life. Now, the final thing we look at is comparable borrowing experience. This has become more critical over the past few years, at least with the people we're dealing with. We find it hard to lend, as do lenders, someone $150,000 if they only have 3 credit accounts that equal $7,000. It needs to make sense. So if a guy's bought in his personal life a $40,000 car, then he's going and applying for a $50,000 truck. That's comparable borrowing experience. But $7,000 worth of credit and $150,000 price tag, well, that's not quite comparable. So those are the six primary things. Now, just like in life, there's always exceptions. There are in lending as well, and we call those exceptions compensating factors. the first compensating factor that lets a dead deal or a deal that may be on the rocks get further down the road is money in the bank. If someone has a large amount of provable cash or is willing to make a larger down payment, we can take a weak deal and give it a fighting chance. Banks like money. The second thing we look for are credit purchases that are not showing. So we're a finance company that focuses primarily on transportation and construction equipment. But recently, we had a borrower that had no trade lines showing and no credit score. But during our interview process with the client, we were able to determine that he had purchased $250,000Peterbilt trucks. Now, we got proof of this. We sent those in to the lender, and he was able to buy the $20,000 trailer that he needed. And it was all because, not because of his credit score, but because we could prove that he had made large purchases before. The last thing that we look at or look for is the equivalent of a cosigner for a business, or it could be a cross-corporation guarantee. Frequently, we'll have like construction companies that will come to us, and they've grown, and they basically have a transportation portion of them and a construction. Well, the liability is different for both of those entities. So frequently accountants or attorneys will say, let's break these two apart. The trucking company will be the new part to this. So what we do is we'll get what's called a cross-corporation guarantee. Even though the trucking company is a startup, if the same principals are running another business that's, it can be related or not, just willing to guarantee the newer or weaker company, a lot of times we can get that deal through. So that's it, folks. We appreciate your time. And if you have any questions, we would love to help you. I can be reached at Fleet Lending Solutions. My name's Kurt Horn. And if you have any topics that you'd like to cover, contact the Education Committee at American Association of Commercial Finance Brokers. Have a great day.